Well, good morning, you two. This is Chris. Me and Steve just showed up on the job site this morning, and we got to grind two stumps and all the roots. That's going to be the hardest. They're taking these two trees down because of she's having problems with the septic tank. The roots are getting in the septic tank, causing a lot of, or the field lines, and causing a lot of trouble. So that's why they took them down. Well, YouTube, we're about finished up for the day. We're going to rake this out, clean this up a little bit better, and then we're out of here. And call it a day on these. We got all the roots, and they're going to pick the pile of mulch up and do away with that. So we don't have to mess with that today. We did it on the last job because I had the Bobcat skid steer there and it was easy to do, and you know, and but let me tell you a little secret about, you know, tree work, or if you're new to the game and you're just starting out and you don't have a clientele, you know, but you're building it up, the cleanup is where the money's at. They're paying you to do a job that they don't want to do at all. They're paying you to grind the stumps. They don't want to rent one, do it yourself. They don't want to take the tree down. Everything they're doing, they're paying you because they don't want to do the job. So if you come out here and if I half-ass it and barely grind these roots and or don't clean it up as well, or you know, they're not going to call you back. So if you're a new guy and you're starting out, don't be half price Charlie or Harry or whatever and grind half the roots and then pull the mulch over the top of it because you want to get a payday and you want to run, you know, run to the next job. Well, you'll never get called back. You'll never, you know, and you always let the customer know what you're going to do. You know what I mean? So like this, I said, I'll grind the stumps and I'll level it out. And if you'll let it rain a good bit, it's gonna settle. These piles is gonna settle down a lot because they're fluffy and they're not compacted yet. So that's one reason why I, you know, leave it. And it's about maybe four or five trash bags, maybe six, if I have to rake it up, you know. But every job's different. Some jobs we haul it off because they want it hauled off. Some jobs they don't want it hauled off. So every job's different. So you just have to, you know, as long as you let the people know, here's how we're going to handle it or what we're going to do, and everybody's clear on it, you'll have no problems. I've been doing tree work for 15 years and I hardly ever do contracts. You know, you have all these people, they're very few people that ever beat you out of anything, and then they're very, I mean, if you just, you know, just do what you're saying, you send them a text saying, hey, I'll cut the tree down, haul everything off, haul the debris off, grind the stumps, maybe leave the mulch if you want to save money that way, and you deal with it, or you haul it off, or I haul it off. So you know, it's pretty straightforward. It's nothing radical about it. I see all these, I'm on these Facebook channels and I hear all these people having trouble out of customers. I heard like four or five this week and I'm like, I don't have that. I mean, I've never, matter of fact, this job, the lady tipped us. The last job I got a tip, I mean a real nice tip. And it's the same way. You show up, you know what I'm saying? I mean, he'll spend 45 minutes blowing this yard and making this nice. You know what I'm saying? If you don't want it, I mean, we could go in and blow and go, man. I mean, I can run it and grind it and go and leave a mess. I mean, that ain't how you get a call back. That ain't how you, when she gets on today, I want her to be happy. I want the customer to be happy. So I'm just giving you an idea. If you're new to the game, that's what you do. If not, then hey, you know what? I mean, me and the guys has become, we've become very successful at this. I mean, all of us. It ain't just me that does it. It's, you know, I have guys, you know, the guys do too, you know. So we share in it. You know, if I get tipped, they get tipped. You know, we split up the money. I mean, that's because they did a great job. And you know, I mean, if you get, I mean, I got tipped one time. The biggest one I ever got was like $1,500. You know what I'm saying? $1,500 ain't no chump change, you know, for a tip. You know, you're going to already clean it up anyway. So, I think his shoulders hurt. All right, we're going to get after it.